smell. The stud farm owner. I saw him in Scallets a few times. His poor widow.
Ask.
I can come back later if you...
No. I saw you came with the soldiers, and the sooner you know everything, the sooner you'll catch those savages.
I'm sorry to trouble you, ma'am, but could you tell me about the raid?
The noise woke us up. Me and Smil. We thought the horses were restless, or maybe some drunk had staggered here from the inn.
Do you get drunks coming here a lot?
Sometimes, but not this time. My husband went out to see what was going on. Then I just heard loud voices and screaming. It's so stupid. It didn't even occur to me at first that something could have happened to Smil. I didn't find out until the morning.
Did you recognize any of the voices you heard?
No, but they spoke Czech, cursing like demons, even at each other.
At each other? They quarreled?
Yes. Something must have happened.
And where did you hear this noise?
Everywhere. It was chaos. I don't even know how many of them there were.
I mean at the very start. Do you remember where you heard the noise come from then?
I don't know. I just don't know.
Did you get a look at them? There's one man, huge, and dressed all in black. Did you see him?
No, I didn't.
Who should I question about the raid? Did anyone here see anything?
From what I've heard, Mark was the first one to wake. It might be a good idea to talk to him.
Jakob, the old stable boy. He even fought with them. Ginger was sleeping in the stable. He might have seen something.
I don't know of anyone else.
Good luck, then.
How could anyone be so cruel? They really did slaughter them. They really did slaughter them. They really did slaughter them. Why would anyone do that? How could anyone be so cruel?
This one got it in the back. And there's more of them over by the main stables.
Poor wretch. He must have crawled here. If it was the horses they were after, there'll be even more of them by the main stables. How could anyone be so...
See what they did here? Kill them! Find those horse hunters! Kill them!
Are you well?
Leave me alone. Go away.
Look, I know that it's difficult.
But I only need you to answer a few questions. I'm here because Sir Radzig sent me.
Sir Radzig?
Yes.
What do you need to know?
What actually happened here?
They killed the animals and... Why did they kill them?
Did they take anything?
No.
Think carefully now. How did it all start?
We heard the animals. Their shrieks. Then Smil. He shouted. And they murdered him.
You're certain it was the animals first, and then Smil? Not the other way round?
I'm certain. I'd never heard a sound like that before. Now I'll never forget it.
What happened after that?
We ran outside and it was chaos. Animals were dying, the stables were burning, and those demons everywhere.
The stables were already burning. Didn't that happen after they fled?
No. It was to set the blaze when they arrived.
You said they were demons?
No, just vermin. Worthless human vermin.
How many of them were there?
Not many. There were just a few that came after us, but more round the back. I heard them yelling at each other.
So they were yelling because of all the noise?
No, something happened. They quarrelled.
In the back? Where?
Towards the woods, to the north. They were trying to get away.
So some of them were running away and the others were fighting?
Aye, for a time. Then more of us came out and we fought back, so the others fled as well.
Where? Where did they run to?
To the north, into the woods.
Did you see a big man among them, dressed all in black?
That cutthroat, that devil! I never want to see him again.
So he was here? That bloodthirsty beast. Thanks. That's all I needed to ask.
God be with you.
Fuck, why?
Such senseless brutality. They slaughtered horses as well as people, and yet it seems they didn't take anything.
What? Who's there?
Easy. I just came to ask...
I don't know anything.
Are you hurt?
No, nothing. Not a scratch.
What really happened here?
I don't know. Someone attacked. I don't know who.
You didn't happen to hear where they came from?
No, I didn't see a thing.
another useless soldier coming to ask questions. You should have fucking been here last night.
What's wrong with your arm? Oh dear. That looks painful.
That's all you gotta say about it. You useless prick.
What in the world happened here?
The bastards attacked us. At night, a little before dawn.
And how did you come by that wound?
I heard someone talking, so I went to look outside. Then I saw what they'd done to the horses. I shouted at those bastards, caught one by the cloak and started beating him.
Without a weapon? With just your fists?
Yeah. But he cut me pretty good, the fucker. Lucky for me, the others started to come out then, so the raiders ran. All that's left is his cloak.
And you've got no idea why they did it?
Something must have gone wrong for them. They ran off without taking anything.
Can you help me?
Help you? And how have you helped me?
May the Lord watch over you.
Understand.
Aha! This wasn't done by animals. They must have gone into the woods this way.
No, I can't leave you here. If they find you,
I know. I wanted to do it myself. I don't
even have the strength for that.
What kind of nonsense is that?
Christ's sake, what other options do I have? I won't make it to camp, and you know it. You want to leave me here to die in agony?
All right, ma'am. How? How should I?
Just do it quickly.
I always do. You know me. Godspeed, brother. Is someone there?
It's a hoof pick. Someone in Neuhof must know more about it.
Do you know whose hoofpick this is?
Ginger's. He was always bragging about it.
Why do you ask?
I found it on one of the bandits in the woods.
But he... Because of him?
Because of him they murdered us? Lord in heaven!
Wait, hold on. You think Ginger was responsible for the attack?
He ran off! Don't you see? He was acting so strange and then he ran off! Why the hell would he do that?
That does sound rather odd. And you don't know where Ginger could have gone?
Dunno. Ask Yakub. Farewell.
Do you know anything about this hoof pick?
Yeah, it's Ginger's. He had it made in Mate.
Any idea where I might find this Ginger?
Well, that's the thing. He packed up and left.
What?
Look, I know how he looks, but Ginger is a fine fellow. I don't believe he had anything to do with the attack.
Where could he have fled to?
I might know, but you gotta promise me one thing. When you find him, listen to what he has to say before judging.
You have my word.
Sometimes the charcoal burners come to see him. He gets on well with them. I think that's where he's gone.
And where is that?
No idea. They've always kept to themselves, you know, charcoal burners.
But the forest is full of folk like that. They could be anywhere.
Aye, except these ones won't be far. If you follow the stream from the stud farm towards Ratte, you'll come across one of their camps. Only...
Only what?
Ginger didn't go that way, though. He always went by the big road, through the woods in the direction of Ujits.
But how can I find them?
There's always smoke when they work. You'll smell them before you see them. And they need to be near water. There's that too.
So if I go through the woods along running water, I'll find them.
Exactly. God be with you.
Yeah. 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 Yeah! Yeah. Yeah.
Why are you waking me?
Huh?
Thank you.
God be with you.
Could you help me?
Depends what you want, doesn't it?
I'm looking for Ginger, a stable boy from Neuhof. They say he ran away and joined up with some charcoal burners he used to hang around with sometimes.
Sorry, there's never been a lad called Ginger around here. You have to try somewhere else.
A murder's been committed at Neuhof, and that boy likely knows who did it. It's vital I find him.
There's been murder aplenty in these parts of late, but that Ginger lad really hasn't been here.
There'll be a lot less murdering going on once I bring those bastards to justice. So how about helping me out?
Calm down, lad. For the love of God, there's been no one like the boy you want round here. But then again, there are other charcoal burners. Try them. You might want to hurry. You're not the first to be asking about him, and the others weren't exactly a noble-looking bunch, although they were generous with their silver.
They didn't happen to say what they wanted him for?
No, but they definitely didn't look like they wanted to invite him to a feast.
Do you have any idea where else he could have gone?
You said he was friends with the charcoal burners? Well, you'll definitely find some in the forest between Neuhof and Ujets. There's good spots around there.
But that forest is huge. I could spend weeks searching.
Then follow the river. That's how you found us, isn't it? Where there's charcoal burners, there's always water nearby.
All right. I'll go and ask somewhere else.
Good luck to you.
Yeah. 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 Yeah! Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
I'll be with you.
I'm looking for Ginger from Neuhof. Do you know anything about him?
I know him. What do you want of him?
There's a few questions I need to ask him.
Well, he'll have to go somewhere else to find him. He doesn't come here much.
I really must speak with him. A murder was committed at the stud farm, and that boy probably knows who did it. I have to get him to talk.
And you think he had a hand in it?
Hard to say. He ran away, but on the other hand, it seems he stabbed one of the attackers.
Well, when you put it like that, it's clearly urgent business. I do know him. Not personally, but I've seen him around. He's friends with the charcoal burners down by Townburg. I know he hangs around with the twins there.
Downstream by Townburg? Somewhere by the castle?
If you follow the river to the west, you're bound to run into them. One more thing.
Yes?
Some other men have been around asking about him, but they weren't as convincing as you.
Oh, well.
God be with you.
Where are you hiding, Ginger?
How did you... What the hell are you talking about?
Don't try that one on me. I know he's friends with a pair of twins from here. I'm here on the orders of Sir Hanush, and I need to talk to Ginger about the raid on the stud farm.
If Sir Hanush sent you, then you should deal with those two cutthroats who've been creeping around here asking about the poor boy. Once you take care of them, we won't have to hide him anymore.
All right, I'll deal with them. And then you'll tell me where you've got Ginger hidden, right?
Right. You get rid of them, and I'll tell you.
So where can I find these bandits?
I'm not sure exactly. There's lots of places to hide around here. But they came and went over the bridge, so I reckon they must be somewhere between here and our neighbours.
That's a lot of woods to comb through.
Not all that much. There's a path around there somewhere leading to an abandoned camp.
Take care now.
Good health to you, sir.
You know something about Ginger?
I might have heard something. And if you share a bit of silver with me, I might share what I know.
I'm investigating a crime, not bartering for a chicken.
Well then, I'm sure you've got some silver on you. Just give it to me, and it'll be a done deal.
And what if I bashed your face in and had you dragged off to the stocks in Rat Eye?
No need for that.
All I wanted was a bit of silver, and instead I get the whip.
Spit it out, will you?
Well, fine. I've heard that they're hiding him in some remote cottage at the edge of the forest on the way to Ushitz.
That didn't hurt too much now, did it?
God be with you.
Yeah.
Marish Melodot. Kurva élet!
Mm.
pyjama.
Yeah! Yeah!
Greetings, my good man. May I ask you a question?
Ask first, then I'll ask you something.
Really? Good then. We're looking for Ginger, a stable boy at a nearby stud farm. Have you seen him anywhere?
I was just about to ask you two the same thing. I'm looking for him too.
Then it's a pity neither of us has found him yet.
Thank heavens I've found you, though. I imagine you two might be able to tell me something about Neuhof. Hmm?
I see. Well, we can give you a little demonstration of what happened there.
You call that combat?
Dupsy Jerry. I'm going to enjoy this.
Fucker!
Come here, Lily Liver. What's the matter? You're dead. Shit.
Gotcha, you dog. You'll soon be sorry for shooting.
dear God.
Good health to you.
You don't have to worry about those bandits anymore. I've dealt with them.
Really? And I suppose I have to take your word for it.
If you want proof, I can take you to them. Maybe I should have brought you their heads.
I'll take your word for it. All right, a bargain's a bargain. Ginger is hiding out in a ruined hut not far from here. You go along the road to Ujit until you see a path to the right that leads to a small spring. There's an overgrown path that leads from there right to where Ginger is. Keep your eyes peeled, though. You could easily miss it.
Good. Thanks for your help.
God be with you.
Jesus, you've led me a merry dance. What do you want from me?
I want to ask you a couple of questions. Why did you run off like that? Where are your cronies? And why did you kill that bandit?
What?
Right, one thing at a time. Why did you run off in such a hurry?
Because I was afraid they'd come back and kill me.
Who?
Those bandits, of course.
To get revenge on you for killing their mate?
Killing? Me? I never killed anyone. God is my witness.
I'm looking for your friends. Where are they?
The charcoal burners? They're over at the...
To hell with the charcoal burners. Where are your bandit mates?
They're not my mates. They nearly killed me. I recognized one of them, so I thought they'd come back and...
Recognize? Who was it? Talk!
I don't know his name, only that he's from Ushets and he has a limp.
What can you tell me about him? How do you know him?
I saw him a few times in the tavern in Ushets, playing dice and boozing.
And?
I know he lives in a house on the edge of the village, but that's all I know. I never talked to him.
Why did you kill that bandit?
What? Bandit? I never killed anyone.
This is yours, isn't it? I pulled it from the belly of a dead bandit near the stud farm.
That is mine, but I didn't stab him. That fellow took it from me.
What fellow?
I don't know his name, but he's from Ujits, and he has a limp.
He limps, and he's from Ujits. That's not much to go on, but I suppose it'll have to do.
It's all I know. I never talked to him.
And now tell me exactly what happened. And don't leave anything out.
That's quite a long story.
Don't worry, I won't get bored.
All right. I woke up in the middle of the night because I needed to go for a piss. So I went out into the dark, same as usual, only there was something there that shouldn't have been. At first I thought it was just a trick of the light, but it wasn't. Then it was too late. They went past, and I thought they must be horse thieves. I would have yelled, only I was afraid they'd kill me. So I waited until they were out of sight, and I started to sneak away. But then...
Then the slaughtering started.
Yes. I thought they'd steal the horses and ride off. That would be bad enough. But then all the killing started, and flames everywhere. Well, it was terrible, like hell itself.
And then...
It seemed some of them didn't like it either. They started squabbling among themselves, and some of them started running back where they came from, right towards me, and I had that thing in my hand, the hoof pick.
So you stabbed the first one in the belly?
No. He ran right into me. He was running fast for a fellow with a limp. He pushed me aside, and I fell on the ground. Then he told me I'd better lie low if I valued my life, and he ran off with the others. I did what he said and hid. Then the rest of the gang ran past.
And then?
Then I waited in case that limping one from Ushits came back. I didn't dare come out until I was sure. I think it was almost light.
What about the others? Was there anything you noticed about them?
I don't know. There might have been maybe 8 of them, and 2 of them were really big. That's all I can remember.
Do you know what they argued about?
I didn't hear everything, but I reckon some of them were only there to steal and wanted no part in the killing.
That sounds terrible. I know exactly how you feel.
If only I yelled. Maybe they...
If you had, you'd most likely be dead. It probably wouldn't have done any good anyway.
But still...
There was nothing you could do. That's all. And now tell me exactly what happened. And don't leave...
That's...
You don't have to tell me everything.
I only reckon...
What else do you know?
Nothing.
I've heard everything I...
Wait! What about...
Perhaps I could.
I'd like to go back to the stud farm, but those cutthroats...
They're out of the way.
Really?
What?
I'm afraid to go back to the farm. I ran away, and God knows what they'll think about it all. I don't know if they'll even want to talk to me.
I could go and ask them if it's important to you.
Would you? You'll definitely have their respect, the way you took care of those cutthroats.
I found Ginger. He begged me to ask if he can return, ma'am.
Why should I take him back? It might be his fault I had to bury my husband.
What?
Why else would he flee but guilt? The men said they didn't see him in bed. He didn't have a clean conscience because he gave those murderers a signal.
That's not true. He fled because one of the attackers recognized him and Ginger was afraid he'd come back and kill him.
Those are just excuses. He wouldn't dare come back.
But they came back the very same day. If he hadn't run, they'd have killed him and everyone else.
But why would they do that?
Why not? They'd already murdered several people, why not a few more?
And now I'm supposed to take him back? What if they come back for him and kill one of my daughters in the process?
The cutthroats who were after him have been taken care of. And the rest have no reason to return here.
And what about for revenge? I can't take him back.
I understand your concerns, but you just need to ask Sir Hanish to leave you a guard. Those bandits might be willing to take on a few stable boys, but not an armed soldier.
I'd definitely feel better if someone was here a few days to keep watch.
It can be arranged. I'm sure Sir Bernard won't object.
Good then. Let the lad come back again. God bless.
Well, well. Look who deigns to grace us with his presence.
I was looking for that boy, and...
And you didn't bother telling anyone.
I had to follow the trail before it went cold.
And what if some bandit skewered you and left you for dead? We'd never find you, because you told no one where you were going. How would I explain that to Sir Radzik, eh? I really don't know, my lord. He disappeared without saying a word to anyone. Never crossed my mind he wanted to get himself killed.
I...
Silence! Keep your ignorant mouth shut when I'm giving you the benefit of a veteran's wisdom. You do what I tell you, answer only when I ask, and not go roaming off whenever you feel like it. I'd like to kick your arse back to the castle and be shut of you. But it's true, you're a fucking peasant who knows nothing about soldiering, and it's my job to whip you into shape, so I'm not done with you yet. God have mercy on you if you ever try anything like that again. If you're lucky, I'll only have you whipped and clapped in the stocks. Because if I get my way, you'll be hanged for desertion. I hope we've got that out of the way. I've made myself absolutely clear. And now, let's hear what you have to report.
I talked to Ginger and found out what happened.
Out with it, then.
Ginger fled because he recognized one of the raiders. He was afraid they'd come back to silence him.
Well, he was right. They were asking about him. So who did he recognize?
He didn't know his name. Some fellow with a limp from Ujits.
All right. Since you've gone this far, you may as well ask around in Ujits. We've enough to do here in these parts anyway. Sir Radzik will tell you about it. He said to send you to him if you haven't already been.
Can you teach me how to defend myself better in combat?
Certainly.
I'd like to practice the basics.
All right, but it'll cost you.
Isn't that quite a lot?
Agreed. Now, listen up. Yeah. Yeah!
You can return home. It was hard work to convince them, so please don't get into trouble when you go back.
Thank you. I'd like to give you something, but I've got nothing, except if you're ever traveling by way of Neuhof, stop by and I'll show you something with the horses.
I'll slay you, you scum. Huh.
Come on!
Is that all you've got?
Ah! Dobre Della! Jesus Christ! Damn!
You're dead!
I'll slaughter you.
You want to cry now? Bring it on! Take that! Is that the best you can do?
Pay up, and I'll let you go.
What's to be done?
Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah.
God be with you, lad. What can I do for you?
My lord, I managed to find a clue to the whereabouts of the bandits.
Excellent. Bernard already told me what's been happening, but I'd like to hear it straight from the horse's mouth.
The whole story, or just the gist of it, sir?
It's up to you what you consider important.
One of the Neuhof stable boys, a lad they called Ginger, fled from there and hid out with some charcoal burners. I have to say, there's a lot of them around. I never thought how many forges and ironworks they have to supply.
That's true, but keep to the point.
Oh, yes, sir. I had quite a job finding him. He was well hidden and with good reason. The bandits wanted to kill him because he recognized one of them.
Did he tell you what happened?
He said it wasn't one gang, but two. And one of them took fright when the slaughter started. Seems they were only interested in loot, so they quarreled with the other lot. Then it came to a skirmish in the woods and one of them was killed. And the rest of them scattered.
And did you find out where they went?
All I know is one of them is from Ujits. I know enough about him to be able to track him down.
All right, but those cutthroats must know who he is too, right? And if they want to get revenge on him or silence him, you'd better hope they don't get to him before you. So drop everything and get on his trail. Find out what he knows and then report back to me. I'm going to our encampment at Merhaya to oversee the security of the region.
Yes, sir. Why choose Merhaya?
It's somewhat at the centre of events, isn't it? And what's more, there's another stud farm there.
Sir, do you think they're going to try the same thing again?
I shouldn't think so. Everyone will be on the alert now, but the secluded dwellings are more vulnerable. There are few people in them. They're scattered everywhere and we can't guard them all.
But the bandits won't find much silver in places like that.
There's always a groschen or two, some food and so on. Anyway, how much silver did they get from slaughtering those horses?
True. If they'd stolen them, they could have sold them. Those were fine animals.
Exactly. It's not about the silver. It's about something else.
But what?
Creating fear. Such great terror that you won't even squeak when they come to cut your throat. Never mind raise your hand against them. Fear that will root you to the spot, staring like a rabbit entranced by a stoat, waiting for the death blow to fall. Helpless to do anything about it.
I have some news about the investigation, sir.
Good. Tell me.
The trail leads to Ujits. I found out one of the bandits is from there, a fellow they call Limpy Lubos.
I see. What else?
That's all I've found out so far, sir.
All right. Come back and report to me as soon as you learn anything new. May the Lord watch over you.
Good day to you.
Any chance of some work here, Captain?
It all depends on what you're ready to do, my lion. As I'm sure you've noticed, the roads around here are swarming with brigands. Sir Hunnish has declared quite a reward for dealing with them.
So what do you think I should do about them?
We know about one of their encampments. It's to the east of Ratai in an abandoned mine. I don't really mind how you deal with them. Anyway, the leaders generally wear spurs, maybe like they're pretending their nobility. Who cares? In any case, bring me the spurs, and I'll take it as proof that the deed's done.
Very well. I'll see to it.
Wait. In addition, Sir Hanush has offered a reward for every bandit who's killed. So take a good sharp dagger. You'll get a bit extra for each ear you bring.
Isn't that a bit barbaric?
Barbaric ways for barbaric times, my boy.
That does make sense, I must admit.
Yeah, well.
Yeah.